aggression nor desperate for goodness. He simply destroys whatever lays in his path.
Braun Strowman is on fire from Saxton. And Sports Entertainment has never experienced brute force like this with one human being.
Oh my goodness, this hurts!
Superstars have been successful against Bobby Roode.
Yeah, that's what makes him so difficult to really game plan for. There's just no established blueprint for success when it comes to competing against Bobby Roode.
Dario vicious head crank.
Look at the torque. Oh, that'll mess up the neck. Watch this. This might be it.
Oh, my.
What a strike. Right on the mark.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
What a slam.
Impactful.
It'll jar your spine.
You gotta believe this one's over.
Harsh impact. Shane proves his worth by stepping into the ring, which is something I don't think a lot of executives would do, let alone go to the extreme that Shane does.
Yeah, for some reason, I don't see many examples.
And Bobby Roode is your winner! Come on, Corey! Hallelujah!
Stop it.
These guys showed flashes in this match, but flashes don't exactly set the world on fire. These highlights show good work.
She's in there with tonight. The good news is that if it gets too out of control, she has her partner she can tag in while she catches her breath in the corner. Her opponent clearly wants to prove a point tonight. And you know what? I think it's working.
Don't do this. Don't get right to the gut. no, this isn't gonna end well.
Smart strategy, attack the knee.
At the elbow, oh my goodness, crushing it. If you want to talk strategy against Asuka, you have to recognize her lethal and sudden offense.
Yeah, if you're looking to neutralize that, you have to know about Asuka's hybrid style. She's mastered so many different elements of the game.
Oh my goodness, crushing it! Now the old vicious head crank. Look at the torque. Byron alluded to Asuka's options through her hybrid style, but her competition's options are often limited to tap or nap. Oh, my last nap, I had dreams about walking down a beach with Asuka. And then I realized I was actually running in terror. Look at Asuka stalking her.
She better stay right where she is.
Irish whip!
For many years, members of the WWE Universe and the WWE locker room have felt that tag team matches should have two referees. One referee is in the ring overseeing the action, and the other is located out on the floor, making sure teams follow the rules and do not engage in potentially damaging behavior. That's a good idea, something perhaps Mr. McMahon might want to consider.
We know what's coming here. Byron raised. Man, she knows how to make a comeback.
Charlotte is in trouble. A risky move, but it seems to have paid off.
You know that movie where you see the ring and 7 days later something really bad happens to you? Yeah, it works the exact same way with Asuka when you see her battle mask. Except it doesn't take 7 days. Bad things happen almost instantly.
Deconstructing the knee there.
Performers, Byron, it's a beautiful disaster.
What a mask of emotions. But when it comes off, you can see it in her eyes. She is ready for battle.
Back in the ring again. Back inside the ring now.
Ooh, that's how you dominate your opponent.
In May of 2017, SmackDown Live saw an incredible women's tag team match when Charlotte Flair and Becky Lynch squared off against welcoming committee members Natalya and Carmella. The rivalry between these women got so intense that Naomi was in Flair and Lynch's corner, and Tamina was in Natalya and Carmella's corner. I think only a group as treacherous as the welcoming committee could bring Becky Lynch and Charlotte Flair back together. Natalya's power set the tone for the match and gave her team an advantage. That was until Carmella's overconfidence let the Irish last kicker turn the tide and get back into the match. And then it was elementary from there for the Irish-born superstar. Naomi did an excellent job of making sure any quote-unquote committee nonsense cost her girls the match. Once Becky Lynch got Carmella locked into this armor, there was nothing for the Staten Island princess to do but to tap out. And it didn't take long for that to happen.
Most of the truly great tag teams in sports entertainment created a double-team finishing maneuver.
The spike pile driver from Anderson and Blanchard. The heart attack from the Heart Foundation. The rocker dropper from the Rockers. Or the doomsday device from the Road Warriors. A team needs to have a tag team finisher and be able to execute that finisher on all types of opponents. Corey, a few moments ago, you mentioned some of the great tag team finishing moves in sports entertainment history. Don't forget about the 3D from the Dudley Boys or the double dropkick from the 2017 WWE Hall of Famers, the Rock and Roll Express. Tag team action like a singles competition. Once a duo nails your opponent with their finisher, that should signal the beginning of the end.
It can take a long time for a tag team to decide on a double team finisher, but I agree. A team needs one, and it should be something that can be administered to any opponent.
That's when a finishing move is truly effective. And since we're talking about tag teams, remember you and your partner have until the referee's five count to execute a move. You know, guys, it's pretty amazing that in just a few short years, Charlotte has earned the moniker the Queen by ruling over every WWE show.
Was made when the first ever SmackDown Tag Team Champions were crowned.
back last 2016. The unlikely duo of Rhino and Heath Slater caught lightning in a bottle and ran through the tag team title tournament. In the finals, Rhino and Slater took on the Usos to see which team would be the inaugural tag team champions.
Trouble. I can tell you nobody's happy about it.